Welcome to my birthday, I guess, my birthday party. This is it. We originally planned to have my party in Italy. I just really wanted to go see my friends in Lucca. I was in Lucca a few years ago, and the reason I guess I fell in love with Lucca so much was I was there with my family, and it was the last proper family holiday we had. And I was walking past a record shop, and I could hear a song of mine blasting out of the record shop. And my mother, who was walking along with me at the time, said, "Glen, that's you." And we went into the shop, and it was the people from Skystone in Lucca. And they, and when I went in, he just said, "Ah, it's you." And we went in, and we joined them in, and we became good friends, and we played some concerts, and I really wanted to have my party there, and it sort of turned out that it wasn't going to work out. And then of course the virus hit and everything, and then we also made a plan to do it in the garden with some friends and bands, and that didn't work. And then we talked about going to Whelan's to have a few beers, and it hasn't worked, so we're here. And so thank you for being here with me. So I sing this to all my friends in Lucca, and all my friends in Whelan's and in Foots Barn, and all the people who were coming to the party. thanks for being here, everybody. You know, in terms of turning 50, and you know, what are you going to, you know, what are you going to do? What are you going to do on your birthday? I had this thing where I really had a grog and a kind of a grog is an Irish word for I really had this kind of, like, it means love, but I guess longing is what I mean by the word, for a beer. And I really wanted particularly a Czech beer. And I noticed somebody yesterday pointed out on the, it was I wrote her name down. Somebody was talking about Czech beer. And, oh yeah, Nikki there on Instagram. And Myra, fair play to her, managed to locate some Pilsner or Quell, which is the best beer, not only in the Czech Republic, but in the world. And so, Nostravi to all our Czech friends out there. It's a real treat to have this. And so I'm pouring my first and very much looking forward to it. This goes to Marek and Jan and all of our, Jesus, I've got so many friends in Czech Republic. A big love to you all, to Marketa and Hedy and Carla and all the Hlaváčeks and all the Urgles and Jiří Hale and all of our great pals, Jurka, Jiří Černý, our dear friends in Czech, Nostravi, to you. Happy birthday. Now, I remember a few years ago, the one thing about having the party in Lucca, or the party in Whelan's, or the party out here in the garden with all the Footsparners, was always with the same aim, which was to have the Frames play. Because whenever it's my birthday, all I want to do is play with the Frames. And I haven't had a chance to do that this year. And probably won't get a chance to do it this year, which is heartbreaking. So I'll play a wee Frames song to mark. To mark the feeling and to mark the day. It's for Colm and Rob and Joe and Graham and Hingo and Johnny and Binzer and Nori and John and Graham. It's for you. The future takes us where it leads. A hedge to scold beneath the waves. Time tells all and we obey. But how can I be mad at you? You did what you did and you followed through. You were the one who always said, forget it and move on. But I'm not sad. Just disappointed. And I'm not mad. I'm just disappointed. And the future got on top of you. The working load it tallied up. You went down beneath it all like anybody would. And I'm just ambling on in this town. I can't get out and it drags me down. And these words don't really fit what I'm feeling now. But I'm not sad. I'm just disappointed. Oh, no way. getting Howard and Claire. And it's Claire's birthday today also, because me and Claire share a birthday. So if you would, back home, very, very quietly, anybody who knows Claire Ledbetter knows what an absolute legend and what an absolute support and what a true, true, deep person she is. Would you please sing along with a happy birthday? I'm not sure we're in this key, but happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Claire. Happy birthday to you. Beautiful. Happy birthday, Claire. Thank you for all the years of incredible friendship and madness. And God, what happens to us all now? You know, what happens with the Frames gig? What happens with future gigs? What happens to all of our friends who make music and all of the crew and the people who are behind all of the people who make music? It's a crazy time. It doesn't look like this thing's going to end anytime soon. And I don't mean that to be pessimistic. It just doesn't look like things are going to really change in terms of our existence, in terms of the musicians. Ability to play gigs and stuff and to travel, and that really, really affects all of our the people who work with us. Promoters, crew, you know, people gathering in large venues or small venues. But I sincerely hope that we figure out a way to go out and connect, because I think connection is a huge part of this, and this is good. But I don't think anything really beats sitting down together in a room and playing music. So it's a kind of a you know, let's hope that one day soon. You know, one of the first things I want to do is, first things I'd love to do when all of this is back to some kind of normality, is to go play some gigs in Italy, because there's been a huge connection with our friends there and and yesterday I received a video that all of our friends in Italy made of my song, A Song of Good Hope. I think we put it up on YouTube yesterday, so please check it out. They did it through all the social distancing, but they did an amazing job, and I was really, truly honoured, and I'm very, very happy to call you all friends. Thank you, and thank you, Carlo in particular, and all the Stoners for your sincere dedication. To get that thing done, because it really blew me away, and what a birthday gift. So here's a song. Call her mercy. Hours and you're doubting your God-given powers, and when you're ready for her mercy and you're worthy, it will come. And you're sneaking round the back door and she's waiting for you no more. And when you're ready for her mercy and you're worthy, yeah, it will come. When the birds are just tuning up still and the dawn breaks in on your windowsill, and when you're ready for her mercy and you're worthy, it will come. It'll come when you're broken, when that heart of yours is finally open, when you're down, down, troubled, when you're lost, buried down beneath the rubble,
for her mercy, and you're worthy. It will come. Mercy, mercy, come into you. Feel her beauty flowing through you. She will unbind you, set the world free. Mercy, mercy, ah, mercy, mercy, come into you, feel her beauty flowing through you, she will unbind you, set the world free.
It's so funny, those, you know, playing these songs. I don't play at home very much. If I'm not writing a song, I never really play the guitar at home. And so it's strange to pull these songs out, because the last time I would have sang that would have been on stage. I guess it was in Prague around November 17th, if I remember correctly, the last night of our tour for This Wild Willing. And it's a strange thing to go back to songs after having not sang them. You kind of feel like you might not remember them. You may not remember the lyrics, and somehow they always seem to come back. And it's a fascinating thing. It's been an amazing day for me. I've been on the phone all day with my family and my friends, and the postman arrived earlier with a bunch of letters and cards, and on a couple of the letters, it was just addressed Glen Hansard, Ireland. And one of them said Glen Hansard, Guinness House, Ireland. I was knocked out that the postman, like whoever in the sorting office was like, you know, I think he lives in Kildare. But it was amazing. And thank you for the wonderful cards. And thank you for all my friends who sent me amazing things. TJ, thank you for the book. I really appreciate the book, and I look forward to getting stuck into it. It's been an amazing day. I have to say, I'm kind of building up for this, and afterwards we have a little fire burning in the back, and we're gonna go out. So the fire there, Myra, and afterwards we'll go out and we'll finish this beer and maybe one or two more. Myra, please. Everybody, listen. Myra's on camera. Please say hello.
Hello.
Myra's the camera woman for the night.
I am.
Okay. You know, I kind of like, I wrote out a list of songs to play for you, but I don't really, I'm not committed to any of them. So if there's anything you'd particularly like to hear, somebody requested this earlier, so I'll. Maybe, Mary, you could jot down if anybody, you know, if there's a particular song that gets called.
Oh my God. Okay. Can you? Yeah. There's plenty.
I'll do this one now. Thank you. scratching at the surface now. And I'm trying hard to work it out. And so much has gone misunderstood. And this mystery only leads to doubt. Yeah, I'm looking for a sign. And this a dark, uneasy time. And if you have something to say, you better say it now. Cause this is what you've waited for. Your chance to even up the score. And as these shadows fall, oh man, before. So if you have something to say, say it to me now. Just say it to me now. Whoa. So right around now, where, you know, we should have been just back from Switzerland, where we would have played a festival there, a festival called Zermatt, and also we would have played in Rene's house, and that would have been a really special time, and we were really looking forward to it. And then we would have been traveling, just after this, we would have been traveling to America, where my brother Dylan was to be married. I really, you know, all of these things, everything's just off. And it's an incredible thing where everything's, like, there's no arguing with it. It's just, it's done. Everything's off. And there's an incredible sort of humility and humbling that seems to be sort of taking place for all of us. I think we're all in a very humble state. Colm said it really well the other night, and that it feels like we're in this kind of almost like a state of grieving or a state of stillness, like we're drifting through space, or like we're, you know, and God knows how long it's going to go on. But I'll sing this for my brother. But also another thing that I should be doing in around now, is getting ready to play some gigs with Interference. Fergus O'Farrell was a dear friend of mine, and for those of you who don't know who I'm talking about, Ferg wrote the song Gold that was in Once, which I'll sing now, and we were meant to be doing some concerts, and there's a beautiful film that was made about Ferg's life, made by his friend Michael McCormick, and it's a truly wonderful tribute to a dear friend. And I really hope that they can find a way to get the film out there to be seen. And it was supposed to have a cinema release in the next couple of weeks. Everything, as we now know, everything's been pushed and cancelled and changed. So this is for Ferg. You'll have to sing along with me on this one, because usually I have the beautiful harmonies of the band, but maybe you'll join me. Thank you. and I love her so. I wouldn't trade her for gold. I'm walking on moonbeams, and I was born with a silver spoon. And I'm gonna be me. I'm gonna be free. When I'm walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea, and if a door be closed, then a row of homes I'd build it, and tear your curtains down. The sunlight is like gold. And you better be you. Do what you can do. When you're walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea, and if your skin was soiled, well, how long do you think before they'd stop digging? And if your life was gold, well, how long? Miss him every day, and this is he's an amazing man, and it's an amazing film, and I really hope that you get to see it, Breaking Out. So did you write any songs down, right?
I did, and there's been plenty there. What I managed to write down were Winning Streak, Song of Good Hope, Good Life of Song,
oh, wow.
Brother's Keeper, Head Along, and Star.
Okay.
And I'm sure there were more, and I'm sorry, I've just did.
Yeah, no, it's all right. Let me see. Now, maybe I could do Winning Streak. Let me see if.
Yes, right. Many people requested Winning Streak.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
Through summer's long and winter's cold, may you always have someone good to hold. And may good fortune wait on every bed. And may your winning streak, may it never end. So roll the dice, boy, 'cause my money's on you. and take my advice now and put your money down too. Cause there's something in the eye you just can't. You can't pretend. Pretend in the opening streak may it never end. And may the sign of the Southern Cross be some comfort to you when you're lost. And may the devil's evil eye pass you by. Well, it's not for glory, I tell you true, that I do these things that I do for you. For a promise I made, now I must defend it. And may your winning streak, may it never end. Cross be some comfort when you're lost, help you when you're all broke down. May the sisters of good brethren turn your dog around. May the devil's evil eye pass you right by. Don't you look back, my friend. And may the sisters of good charity take you in through summer's long and winter's cold. May you always have someone good to hold. And may good fortune be a constant and a loyal friend. And may your winning streak, may it never end. May your winning streak, may it never end. May your winning streak, may it never end. See, I forget the lyrics because I don't play the songs until I'm playing a gig, so it's kind of, it's like the first gig back is always the practice one. There's a confession for you.
Now, yeah. Glen, I see somebody who might want to say a quick hello.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah.
So can I see?
I'm trying to do it. Oh, God. Technical problems.
No problem.
No, there are. There is. Okay, it's not happening. So.
Okay. We'll try again.
We'll try it in a minute.
Right. So, I wanted it. Well, I was actually asked to sing the this song that I wrote, "Leave a Light." Leave a Light for a couple of people. And I just would like to. Let's see if it works. Or should we go some other direction? I'm not sure. But I wrote a few things down just because I was reading through some of the comments. Say It to Me Now was for Jenny. I wanted to sing that for Jenny TK, which I forgot to do, but now I do. Kat's son is turning 12. The parting glass for Alfreda from the Grave Diggers. Yeah, so maybe I'll try to get to that. Melody Callender is turning 39 today. Happy birthday, Melody. Elizabeth's book is 50. You're 52. We're joining in the club together. Brilliant. Apparently Rome. I heard this. Somebody posted this. Apparently it's Rome's 2,773rd birthday today. Does that even make sense? It sounds like Rome would be around longer than that, but maybe I'm wrong. maybe showing my ignorance there, but... Rome's 2,773rd birthday. Debbie Stewart, happy birthday. Anne's mother turned 60. Happy birthday, Anne's mother. Rex. Oh yeah, Rex. Happy 5th birthday, Rex. Your parents played Falling Slowly at the wedding. Now I probably won't get time to get to that but I did sing that the other night? No, I should sing that, shouldn't I? Well, maybe I've got so many to sing. Let me see. Now. What do I want to do? I'll do this. I'll do this for the young lad. I want to sing this for Yeah, let's sing this. I want to sing this for Rosabelle, young Rosabelle, and let's see where to go. Teach me how to shine, teach me so I know what's going on in your mind. Cause I don't understand these people saying the hill is too steep. Well, they'll talk and talk forever, but no rest will they find. Down into these situations, bringing out the best in you. You're flat on your back again and start. Hear every word I'm heeding. Can you help me to see? Cause I'm lost in the dark. Yeah. Star, teach me how to shine, teach me so I know what's going on in your mind. Cause I don't understand these people saying we're all asleep. Well, they'll toss and turn forever, but no rest will they find. Star, teach me how to shine.
So there's somebody who would really like to join you, but I keep pressing the button and it's just not happening.
Give us a look. Let me see if I can.
Yeah, I'll let you.
I'll have a go. Okay.
People can see you there as well.
Can they see? Oh yeah. Do I have to slip this around? Okay.
So you press this.
Oh, okay, let's have a look.
There's about 100 and something people who want to join you.
Oh, my goodness.
But it's not working anymore. It was coming up.
Ah.
And now it's not coming even when I press it.
Okay.
A list would come up.
I wonder what we should do. Okay. What's that?
No, that's not it.
That's not it. Oh, God, what did I just do? Oh, Jesus. Stay with us, everybody. Hang on.
It's just not... I've been doing that for about 15 minutes.
Oh, yeah?
I managed, yeah.
Let me see. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. We're going to just log off for 1 second and come straight back on. So, everybody, stay right there. Okay, 1 second. Yeah, let's have a quick look. Okay.
It's just that it's not.
Oh, yeah?
It really will.
So, let me see. Where now? Are you guys back?
I can take.
Let me see. Let me go through here.
Okay, let's wait a minute because people are coming.
Oh, yeah.
I can take it from here.
Okay. Let's see what happens. We're not a particularly technical household. The other day I actually had to ask everybody online how to do the Instagram live thing. And thankfully my cousin Amy rang me and gave me a quick lesson. So whatever technical thing I have, Myra is a little bit behind that again. So we see.
I'm saying nothing. Is that? Yeah.
So, how are we doing, Mara?
I'm just waiting kind of for people to catch...
Sorry about that, we had to jump off and jump back on.
Catch up. Okay, there's a couple of people, so I'll... Shall I?
Yeah,
I think
please.
I can do it now, I believe. So,
please do.
Here we go. So that you can see who it is.
Ah, no way! Brother! Ah, Jesus.
Ah, there you go.
I think we got it.
Ah, thank you.
Did we get it? Can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear. Good to see you, brother. Ah, Jill, how are you? Ah, thank you so much. I'm blown away.
She's my technical advisor. That's not why it went wrong. It's just that, you know, the thing about technology, you hear what it says.
Yeah, exactly.
Hit the right button, and it still don't work.
I know, man. I know. But it's kind of part of it, isn't it? It's kind of part of this thing we're doing, which is just, it's a whole new way of doing a gig, a whole new way of connecting with people and saying hello, you know? Oh, you look great, brother.
Back at you. It's part of... I was sitting at the typewriter this morning. I wrote a few words for you. I'm gonna read them.
Oh, thank you.
To you. But before I do that, how's your mom?
My ma's good. We spoke to her today. She's good. She's holding up well, and she's enjoying the madness of it all. And she keeps going, "How are you doing? Are you staying well? Are you isolating?" So she's checking in on us all. It's almost like she's amazing. She's kind of mothering us, you know. She's making sure we're all okay when it's really, it's her we're all concerned about. But she's doing what mothers do, you know.
Well, and speaking about mothers, it is also my mom's birthday. She's there not only with you, but also Claire. I didn't know it was Claire's birthday.
Yes.
Well, so let me raise a Guinness. Well, a Guinness.
Mexican Guinness.
Let me raise a Guinness.
Oh, no. Have I lost you?
I lost you. Oh, yeah. Am I back?
Yeah, we're back.
Okay, I'm not raising a Guinness. I'm raising a Guinness glass. Got my name on there.
Oh, my God, it does. Jesus, I remember
obviously
that.
It's not a Guinness.
Mexican Guinness.
Jill said that she would run and get some food crawling for me. it's not the first one I've raised to you already today, even though we're a little earlier than you.
Oh, thank you.
But happy birthday, Glen.
Thank you, brother. We're going in.
Happy birthday to my mom, Claire. With my the irony of what I'm drinking in this glass is not only the blasphemy, but the irony.
I wonder what's going to happen with Corona after this. Will people ever drink it again? I know you will.
By the way, it's great to see you busking from your house. You've been preparing all your life for this pandemic.
It feels great, man. It feels great to connect because it's sort of, you know, you really get a sense that people are out there at home and they're not connecting and they're, you know, they're struggling a bit. And, you know, I'm gonna come right back at you with this.
You win.
So I have to.
As you should.
Wait, it's blasphemy to drink it out of this glass.
Pour some into mine. Can you see the screen? Yeah. Pour a little bit. There you go. Just a drop will do me. Just a dab will do
me. Yeah, exactly.
What was the name of the pub next to the cemetery where we I had my favorite Guinness of all time?
Gravediggers.
Myra.
The Gravediggers.
Mm-hmm.
There's a pub in Dublin called the Gravediggers, and it's called the Gravediggers because it's right beside the cemetery, and the men used to serve pints in on the spades, you know, so the people would stick their spades out through the cemetery and the barman would stick the pints on the spades and they'd pull them in and drink them. So it's a great bar. We had a great day there.
The shovel, yeah. Well, Glen, it's been an eventful life, yes.
No doubt, man. I'm full of blessings today. I'm really loving it.
Yeah. I just know from some just the events of you and me alone have been, that would qualify. You know, seeing other groups or hanging with Bruce or our travels.
Yeah.
I'm just so grateful. I just want to tell you How many years has it been for us two? When did we meet? I know it was that you were in the Northwest playing. And
it's 10 years, Eddie. It's 10 years.
Oh, that's all?
Yeah. I've known you a lot longer than you've known me.
I think we fit a good 20, 25 into 10. That was good.
Yeah.
That's what late nights will do for you.
Exactly. No, we definitely, you're the best late night partner of the wall.
Well, of all, you know, just some of the best friends you could ever have, you know, best friends, they aren't just friends, they actually change your life. And I just want to tell you that you've changed me. You've made me a better person, a better singer, a better brother, a better bandmate, a better partner.
And you.
And I've laughed harder and I've loved even more. So I'd like to, I'm not going to sing a song today, but I'm going to read you a little something.
Thank you.
But let me just say again, I even had to write this part. I've loved every minute of every tour we've ever embarked upon together, and there's been more than a few. Your stories, your life stories are incredible, in which, upon retrospect and on a day of looking back, it's a remarkable life already, and it's less, you know. Okay,
amazing. Please come back. Yeah, you're back. You're back.
Screen comes on. Olivia, I think, wants to say happy birthday too.
Ollie!
Hey!
How's it going?
I'm okay, how are you?
I'm brilliant. Bit of a dry cough and a temperature, but I'm all right. I'm just kidding, I'm just kidding.
Don't even mess with that.
It's almost like see Olivia stepping back from the screen. No, I'm good, thank God. Thank God. We're all good, and sorry if that was a bad joke. It's good to see Olivia.
Yes.
Your songs are beautiful.
Okay, can I do a little switch around here? All right,
please.
I'm just going to read a few words from the typewriter. So
yeah,
we're going to switch around. I'm going to show you an image, and then I will come back with you. Okay?
Thank you.
Oh, but I can't.
Oh,
we got you.
Oh my God, look at that.
We got you.
Yes, you got me. It looks amazing.
Okay, hear me out here. You just have to listen.
Yes.
VH50. Ah, Glenn. Holy fuck. 50 years. They say it's 50 times around the sun. That may be true. But I think of you as a tree with 50 rings, starting small in the center, just the size of a quarter, maybe a dime, and 50 rings of life expanding out concentrically and perfect. In perfect, imperfect circles. And each year wider with wisdom, strength, and experience. You are fueled by fertile soil where the strongest of roots first took hold. And in order for that homestead dirt to be fertile, it had to have a certain amount of shit. Good shit. For that is where the nutrients lie. Your soft earth was packed with powerful shit.
Oh,
and in the organic, I'm changing pages. In the organic fuel of refuse and the decomposed. There you go.
Oh, that's amazing.
Your growth is not over yet.
Oh,
your
yeah.
growth was then aided and abetted by 50 years of liquids, not liquors, that came later, but liquids. You went from breast milk, you went from breast milk to water. You went from breast milk to water. And then your sapling self was further watered by the presumptive Irish rains.
Oh, wow.
There we go. Was further watered by the presumptive Irish rains, which soon passed the baton to the dark colored Guinness. Again, with its grain.
Wow.
But there's another element that you needed. And my friend, I'll read this a little bit. And my friend, found the heat of the sun. The sun that gave its vitamins by miraculously finding its way through the ever-present shadows of the seven towers to shine its bright reflection off a young Glen Hansard's face. It caught the eyes of an amazing child who had songs in his bones and a longing for love and big futures in his heart. And those rays of light placed its glimmer into those Irish irises, the same ones that have never lost their kaleidoscope beaming qualities, the ones that still emit and emote like a hallway towards a soul alive and true. Glen, your shows are like branches, like limbs for the crowd to climb, and you take us ever higher, higher than the last time. Melodies and stories that remain visions in our minds. Over the years, Glen, these wide branches of leaves have broadened so wide. So many songs from one tree, like a one-man arbor. It's easier for a tree to reach high into the sky when its seed is planted on the highest mountain. But to reach those heights from below sea level takes a bit of magic and a hell of a drive. And sometimes when your ma tells you to reach for the clouds, you reach the fucking stars.
Oh, brother, thank you.
Okay, so 50 years. 50 years we know because of the dates. April 21st, 1970. April 21st, today, 2020. This is the beauty of calendar days. Because we just add up the numbers and we believe what they say. Because otherwise, Glen, to find your age, we'd have to cut the tree that is you in two to count the rings. Wait, hold on. Let me just show. Oh, yeah. To count the rings. Oh, one sec.
Oh.
Because otherwise, gee, we would not believe that you are 50. Because your outside bark is looking pretty good. I love you. We love you.
Thank you so much.
You're a bird.
Oh, my God. That's amazing.
Happy 50 rings.
Thank you, brother. I'm so blown away.
We toast you now.
Thank you. Thanks, Jill. Ed, you're beautiful. Thank you. I'm knocked out. What a day today.
We love you so much. We love you, Myra.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Play the song, will you?
Yeah, okay. Okay. Okay, well, it's that time, I suppose, yeah. Damn.
Should we say goodbye? Okay, we're going to say goodbye.
Yeah. Mwah. Thank you so, so much. Thank you. Wow, that's so beautiful, man. Oh, thanks, Ed. Wow. I suppose it's that time, right? So I'll sing this for Ed and for Jill and for all of you, and thank you for just being here and for helping me celebrate my 50th. This what a wonderful way to do it. I'm truly knocked out. Yeah. As you can see. Maybe it's something about whenever you drink a pint of Guinness, something happens and you want to... Sing this for Mrs. Vedder. Happy birthday. On Raglan Road, of an autumn day, I saw her first and knew that her dark hair would weave a snare that I might one day rue. I saw the danger, yet I passed along the enchanted way. And I said, let grief be a fallen leaf at the dawning of the day. On Grafton Street in November, we tripped lightly along the ledge of a deep ravine. Where can be seen the true worth of passion's pledge? And the queen of hearts still vacant hearts, and I not making hate, for I love too much, and by such is happiness thrown away. Oh, I gave her gifts of the mind, I gave her secret sign that's known to the artists who have known the true gods of sound. And with word intent, I did not stint. I gave her poems to say with her own name there and her own dark hair like clouds over fields of May. Oh. On a quiet street where old ghosts meet, I see her walking now. Away from me, so hurriedly, my reason must allow that I have loved not as I should a creature made of clay. For when the angel woos the clay, he loses his wings at the dawn of day. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for being part of this now. I think our time is up. I really, really appreciate everybody joining us. And what a birthday it is. And after this now, we'll go sit in the garden, me and Myra, and we'll have a beer, and we'll give thanks to all of this. It's such a wonderful, I'd love to sing Mick Christopher's Hey Day, or I'd love to, you know, but I think it's just, I think Leave It There is kind of the feeling. That Eddie chiming in there just blew me away. I'm kind of knocked out, a bit emotional about that. I'm so glad to see him, and I'm so glad his family are safe. Oh, and Myra's made the cake. Oh, look. Oh, thank you, Myra.
beautiful. Wow. Is that it? Is that what I think I'll leave it there. I think I'll leave it there. And I thank everybody. Mary, you want to say?
I just want to give voice to all the beautiful comments that kept coming in from the very beginning that Glen couldn't see because I was behind the camera. And I'd like to not only thank those people, but just give voice to them and tell Glen that all over the world he's loved and revered. And there was a great feeling of festivity and like a public holiday. So it's yes.
Please, everybody, mind yourselves. I know it's a bloody tough time, and it could go on and on for a while. But it's please mind yourselves and just take care of yourself. And I know the distancing is a pain, and it's very difficult to do. I know it from here, but it's the only way to slow this down. And it's the only way to stop it. And we're with you. And if it means doing this every week just to stay in contact, I'm game. I just, if there's any way thing we can do to ease the suffering and the boredom, maybe, and the longing. But actually, I've found it to be quite a deep time, and quite a powerful time. A time to listen, actually. It's not a hugely creative time for me yet. I find it more a time to listen and tune into what's going on outside of me and inside of me. So thanks for helping me celebrate my birthday today. And I'm knocked out. I really am. Thank you, everybody, sincerely. Bye-bye.